Hello, hello, good day. For this day, of course, we will be discussing your community health nursing 100-point item na Q&A with rationalization pag-usapan natin. And these are the hottest, these are the commonly asked questions po sa ating community health nursing concept sa ating Philippine Nurse Licensure Examination. So, to begin this one, by the way, may I just remind everyone na kapag pinag-uusapan po natin ang CHN or Community Health Nursing, there are some distinct concepts po na dugtong si CHN sa ating obstetrics, sa ating maternal, sa ating pedia, sa ating medical surgical. However, may distinct concepts po tayo pagdating sa CHN na kakaiba po. Okay, kapag inihambing natin sa maternal and child health sa medical surgical nursing. Okay, and remember that we are about to take the Philippine Nurse Licensure Examination. Another reminder rin po sa ating mga magti-take to, of course, no, dahan-dahan po tayo sa pagbabasa ng mga NCLEX concepts. It's because those are, okay, ang NCLEX po, saan po yan requirement? It is a requirement in the United States, in Canada, and also in Australia. So you remember that you are about to take the Philippine Nurse Licensure Examination. And there are some concepts na hindi pinag-uusapan sa Pilipinas pero included sa NCLEX. And I tell you guys that ibang-iba po talaga. Because we are going to take the Philippine Nurse Licensure Examination, an examination na tinatanong ang mga services in a Philippine health setting. That's why very, very distinct po talaga mga concepts dito. Okay? So now let's start with your question number one. Sabi sa number one, which of the following is not true about Bemong facilities? Sabi sa letter A, it provides antibiotics. Letter B, it provides oxytocic drugs. Letter C, it can remove placenta. Or letter D, it conducts cesarean delivery. Okay. Now guys, for this question, remember, ang hinahanap natin dito is not true sa Bemong facilities. But first, let's try to understand ano ba ang Bemong facilities na ito. Your Bemong class is your basic, isulat ninyo, it's your basic emergency. Okay, isulat ninyo, it's your basic emergency. That's why it's BEM. Okay, obstetrics, Bemong, and newborn. And newborn care. Yan. Basic, okay? Emergency obstetrics and newborn care. So, ano daw ang mga Bemong na ito? Class, simply lang. Ang mga Bemong po na ito, these are actually your BHS or your barangay health stations, or it could also be your RHS class na kung saan pwedeng mga naksinanay na buntis. Okay? Now, ang mga services po na available dito, correct po ang letter A, ibig sabihin mali iyan because ang hinahanap natin ay not true. Okay? They also provide oxytocic drugs such as oxytocin, which also makes letter B wrong. Okay? And it has actually also the capacity to manually, remember, it can remove the placenta but by manual removal of the placenta, which also makes letter C wrong. So the correct answer for this question is letter D. It conducts cesarean delivery. Cesarean delivery class, remember, this is provided in your Semong facility. When we say Semong, these are your comprehensive emergency obstetrics and newborn care facilities. So the correct answer for this question is letter D. Okay? Now let's proceed to your next question, number two. It is the comprehensive tool used in healthcare delivery system in the Philippines to monitor the progress of mother's pregnancy. Sabi sa letter A, is it FHSIS? Letter B, PEDSAR? Letter C, HBMR? Letter D, DreamH? Okay, remember that your FHSIS, this is a reporting tool. Okay, this is a reporting tool. Reporting tool siya from the RHU level hanggang sa national level ng DOH. So, this is wrong. Okay? Now, letter B, this PEDSAR class, this is also a strategy of the government in reporting of your communicable and non-communicable diseases. Okay? Non-communicable diseases. So, itong PEDSAR class, this is under actually your disease surveillance program. Okay? Disease surveillance program. Isulat po ninyo, disease surveillance program. So, ibig sabihin class, this is wrong. Okay? Letter B is wrong also. So, letter C or letter D, DreamH, alam na alam natin yan, that is for disaster. disaster risk reduction. Okay, disaster risk reduction for health. Okay, so the correct answer for this question is of course letter C. Ang ibig sabihin po ng HBMR, this is home-based mother's record. Okay? Home-based mother's record. Ito po class yung tinatawag nilang diary ni nanay. Yan. Okay, na dyan po nakasulat ang lahat ng mga progress ni nanay sa kanyang pregnancy. At ito rin po ang pinapakita sa mga facilities once mga anak na si nanay. Ang tawag natin doon is home-based mother's record. And this is actually the tool that was prescribed by the World Health Organization at ginagamit din natin sa Pilipinas. Okay? That's procedure number 3. At minimum, how many times should a mother visit the community health center for a prenatal checkup? Okay, how many times daw? Sabi sa letter A, once. Letter B, twice. Letter C, thrice. And then letter D, 4. Alam nyo, simple lang ang mga sagutan sa mga ganitong tanungan. Okay, dahil tinatanong dito ang kabutihan para kay nanay, of course, you answer how many times or yung mas pinakamarami. Kasi the more the marami na bumisita si nanay sa health center, okay, the more na mas ma-check siya at ang progress also at development ni baby. So the correct answer for this question is letter D. D is the correct answer. Wala nang iba. Okay? Let's proceed to your number 4. In community health nursing, a nurse daw conducts the first step in Leopold's maneuver. Okay? Ulit. In community health nursing, a nurse daw conducts the first step in Leopold's maneuver. Alam na natin to. Sabi sa letter A class, ano daw ang goal natin in our first maneuver in Leopold's maneuver? Sabi sa letter A. Letter A, identify the type of presentation. Okay? Letter B, to check the number of babies. Letter C, okay? To check engagement. Letter D, to check the fetal back. Of course, alam natin to kapag sinabi natin pong Leopold's maneuver. Okay, when we say Leopold's maneuver class, ang hinahanap po natin dito sa the first step actually towards in your Leopold's maneuver class, we identify, alam natin to, the presentation or the type of presentation. That's why we locate the fundus. Okay, ang first maneuver po natin is what we call as your fundal grip. Okay? The type of presentation, that's why the correct answer for this one is letter A. At ang tawag natin dito is your fundal, isulat ninyo, it's your fundal grip. Okay? Isulat ninyo, it's your fundal grip. Fundal grip po ang tawag natin dito. Okay? Let's proceed to your number 5. Number 5 is asking, when a pregnant asks daw for a dietary advice, the nurse is correct when he suggests or when he or she suggests to, okay, sabi sa letter A, increase the calorie by 1,000 calories. Letter B, increase calorie by 500 kilocalories or calories. Letter C, increase calorie by 300 calories. And letter D, do not increase calorie. Okay, basically wrong na wrong po dito ang letter D. Okay, mali yan, i-eliminate mo na yan. And then, there is really a need for us to increase the calorie ni mother. Simply because, the dietary advice na binibigay natin kay mother should be anchored on the reality that dalawa na silang nabubuhay. Okay, sa katawan, we have the mother and of course the developing baby. And in this case class, there should be an increase. But the question is how many or how much? Okay, gaano nga ba kalaki? Now, letter C class, okay, remember that letter C class is the correct answer for this question. Okay, letter C is the correct answer for this question. Wrong si letter D, letter B is also wrong, letter A is also wrong. For this question class, the correct answer here is letter C. Remember the number 300. 300 class, 300 is given for, okay, the 300 calorie increase is given for pregnant mothers. Okay, upon the other hand class, si letter B, tama sana si letter B kung ang tanungan, because we increase by 500 kapag ang tinatanong class is how many increase are we going to give for a lactating mother? So the answer for that would be 500. But in so far as this question is concerned, the correct answer is letter C. Increase calorie by 300 calories. Okay? Letter C is the best answer. Number 6. To monitor thyroid glands in the community, the nurse may suggest clients to what? Okay. Sabi sa letter A, to warm compress the neck twice daily. Letter B, to massage the neck once daily. Letter C, to massage the neck twice daily with oil. Letter D, to simply palpate the neck. Alam nyo, letter A, B, and C, kung mapapansin ninyo class, they are more of a complex na ginagawa, because this is also actually a self-management or a self-assessment na ginagawa natin dito. Ano daw yung isasuggest ni public health nurse? So, of course, letter A is wrong. Okay, letter A is wrong class. Hindi natin wina-warm compress ang neck, ha? Okay, letter B, massage the neck with oil. Mas lalong walang oil, okay? Letter C, of course, may oil pa rin. Tapos, twice pa. So, the correct answer for this question is simple palpation class, daily class, is a way, no, to assess, okay, the presence of goiter, okay, in layman's term. Okay, sulat ninyo, goiter in layman's term. Goiter kasi ang tawag natin dito class in layman's term. Okay, answer class is letter D is the best answer. Number 7. In a client currently on exclusive breastfeeding, the nurse is correct to advise which of the following? Sabi sa letter A, breastfeed at least 8 times a day. Letter B, feed the baby at least 6 times in the day. Letter C, breastfeeding at night time should be lesser than in the daytime. And letter D, all of the above. Remember, class, in breastfeeding, remember that in breastfeeding your baby, you should be doing it 8 times a day. Okay, at least 8 times a day, ha? And in dividing this 8 times class, 75% should be done during the daytime. 75% daw should be done at the daytime. Okay, may araw. May araw pa. Okay? Upon the other hand, class, 25%, isulat ninyo, 25% should be done during the nighttime. So, ibig sabihin, kung 8 times ka, 6 times dapat during the day, and then twice during the night. So, insofar as letter A, B, and C, they are all true. So, the correct answer for this question is letter D, all of the above. Okay? The correct answer for this question is all of the above. Okay, next question, number 8. Family's decision class for family planning should be facilitated by the community health nurse. At, okay, sabi sa letter A, before pregnancy. Sabi sa letter B, later part of pregnancy. Later daw, okay? At the later part, siguro kapag malapit ng mga anak. Sabi sa letter Z, after delivery. Sabi sa letter D, the nurse should not intervene. Okay, ang sumagot po sa letter D, ibig sabihin tamad kang pasyente. I mean, tamad kang nurse. Okay, sabi sa letter A, B, and C, before pregnancy, later part of pregnancy, or after delivery. Actually, the correct answer for this one, so that maging prepared po ang family class, it should not be before pregnancy, because you are targeting nga pregnancy itself, no? Also, letter A is wrong. So, the best answer for this, if whether it's later or after pregnancy, of course, it's always later part of pregnancy. During pregnancy, but at the late part of our pregnancy. So, B is the correct answer. Okay? Number 9. Which of the following is true about home birth deliveries? Alin daw sa mga sumusunod ang totoo, no, about home birth deliveries or home deliveries? Sabi sa letter A, it is not allowed at all times. Sabi sa letter B, it may be allowed in some instances. Sabi sa letter C, it must be attended by a doctor only. Letter D, none of the above. Okay, sabi sa letter A, allowed daw siya at all times. Okay, so the question is, ano daw ang totoo about sa home deliveries? And basically, alam na alam natin to. Okay, so the correct answer for this one is letter B. You know what? Home deliveries is now, remember, allowed. Okay, going back, allowed na ang home deliveries, class, ha? Okay, letter C, please, class, avoid those options, class, na may mga dangerous words like your only at all times, okay, for letter A. So, these options are wrong. So, our home deliveries, class, are now allowed depending upon the presence of our healthcare provider. It can be our license or also your TBA or your traditional birth attendant. Basta trained sila, class, okay? As long as they are trained, as long as they have the capacity, as long as we have TBA, we have a license, a health practitioner in the community, home birth is actually allowed. Okay? So, The correct answer for this question is letter B. Number 10. Which of the following situation would qualify for a home delivery? Ito na yun. Sabi sa letter A, when it is attended by a healthcare provider. Letter B, when pregnancy is in full term. Letter C, when there's no signs of bleeding during pregnancy. Letter D, all of the above. Of course, no? So, ang mga qualifications po to allow class your home deliveries would be these the following. Okay? Number one, kapag full term po ang pregnancy. So, this is number one. Okay? Number two class, less than 5 ang pregnancy. Number two class, dapat less than, okay, 5 ang gravidarum or gravity. Okay? Now, number three class, as long as it should be cephalic in presentation. Okay? And, of course, number four, negative when it comes to diseases. Okay? And also class, no history or negative class ang history class ng complications. Okay, ano nung mga complications na yon? Hemorrhage or bleeding during pregnancy, no previous CS class, okay, yun na yon. And also, of course, class, dapat mayroong tayong licensed health practitioner, which can be your RN, it can be your RM, it can be your, of course, your MD or your doctor in the community. Now, in the absence of these three class, we can have your TBA, your traditional birth attendant, or your HILOT, but they should be trained, class ha. They should be trained because the Department of Health is now actually training our TBAs or our traditional birth attendants. So the correct answer for this one is all of the above. Alam natin yan. Okay? All of the above ang best answer for this question. Number 11. Which type of pelvis is the most desirable for birth? Alam natin to. Ang correct answer for this one is gynecoid. Okay? According to Adel Pelletieri class, it's really the gynecoid, which is also common among women. Okay? At ang more common dito among men is your android. Okay? Tandaan ninyo. So, the correct answer for this question, the most desirable for birth. Okay? Because it has the most desirable pelvic outlet. Okay? The correct answer, letter D, gynecoid, is the correct answer. Number 12. 3 C's in home delivery includes the following except. A. Clean hands. Letter B, clean delivery surface. Letter C, clean cutting cord. And then letter D, clean water. So, ang tandaan natin, ang 3 C's natin po dito, the 3 C's po natin includes clean hands, clean delivery surface, and then clean cutting cord. Except letter D. So, letter D po ang answer dito. So, ang hinahanap natin is yung mali. So, of course, letter D is the correct answer kasi may except. Okay? So, letter D, clean water. We don't have clean water class in your 3 C's. Previously class, ang ginagawa, noong unang panahon, no, in the delivery, immediately upon birth, minawash po natin si baby, but that's not anymore practice today. Okay? So, ang ginagawa natin today is immediate drying through the unang yakap protocol or the EINC. Okay? The essential intrapartum and newborn care. Okay? So, let's proceed for this question number 13 na po tayo. Who of the following is not allowed to attend to a home delivery? Okay? Letter A, nurse. Letter B, midwife. Letter C, TBA or traditional birth attendant. Letter D, none of the above. Sinabi na natin to, i-add lang natin si MD at or si doctor. Kompleto na po ang ating cast. Okay? Therefore, the answer for this one is none of the above. Uulitin ko po, as long as si TBA or si traditional birth attendant po are trained. Okay? Trained po dapat si traditional birth attendant. Number 14. In public health nursing, what should the nurse do when the family asks what to do with the placenta after delivery? Letter A, suggest to sell it to beauty products manufacturer. Letter B, facilitate to bury it at the doorstep. Letter C, ask the family where they plan to bury it. Letter D, tell them to dispose it in the garbage. You know what? Napakasimple lang po ng konsepto dito. Kapag daw nanganak si pasyente, yung placenta, usually, may mga rituals ang mga family dyan. Usually, they have a certain transcultural belief which should be respected. Okay? Now, si letter B class, although may bury na word, but at the doorstep, which is very, very suggestive and conclusive. So, you do not suggest class. You just facilitate kung saan ba dapat or saan nakakapag-decide ang pasyente or ang pamilya ng pasyente kung saan nila gustong ilibing yung placenta. Okay? So, for this question, of course, the best answer is letter C. Ask the family. You need to facilitate. You ask the family where they plan to bury it. Okay? Letter A is suggestive ng mukhang perang nurse. Okay? Of course, those are wrong options. Also, letter D, tell them to dispose, is not the best answer. So, letter C, ask the family where they plan to bury it. Okay? Kapag tinatanong kayo klase ng basis natin dito, we follow the transcultural nursing theory, transcultural theory by Madeline Leininger. Ayan. Okay, sulat ninyo, Madeline Leininger. Okay, Madeline Leininger, my favorite theorist. Okay? Madeline Leininger, transcultural theory. Okay, let's proceed to your question number 15. What tool is used in PHN to monitor the development of children? Okay, now, basically, you eliminate letter A kasi it's not for children. Remember, I underline ko lang yung children. Kanina, sinabi na natin that home-based mother's record classes ginagamit natin for monitoring ng progress ng pregnancy ni mother. But it's not for children. Letter B, growth monitoring chart. Letter C, diary ni mommy. Uulitin ko. It's not about mommy. Okay? So, the correct answer for this question is, of course, alam natin to, the growth monitoring chart ni baby or ni bata. Okay? Start with your number 16. So number 16, for proper reporting of cases of community births, the birth attendant should be responsible for the registration of the birth in the, sabi sa letter A, local civil registrar. Letter B, kapatid, FHSIS coordinator. Letter C, city health unit. Or letter D, all of the above. Remember class, na kapag sinabi po nating birth attendant, okay, it can be your RN, pwede rin po si midwife, RM, pwede rin po si, of course, our, usually it's the MHO or the doctor, no, in the community na assigned. So, the best answer for this one, tama po na responsibilidad po ni nurse or ni midwife or ni doctor class ang pagpaparehistro class to the local civil registrar, no? So, or the LCR. Actually, pwede ngang pumirma ang ating mga doktor, ang ating nurse, even the midwife class, sa mismong live birth po ng bata. Okay? Sa pagpapatotoo, natotoo na na-exist, okay? Ang birth ng specific baby. Okay? It is also his or her responsibility to report it to the FSHIS coordinator and also the city health unit, okay, for proper reporting. So, the correct answer for this question is, of course, all of the above. Okay? You get it right. Okay. Next, number 17. When should the public health nurse visit a postpartum mother after birth? Ito class, don't be confused with this question, ha. The question is asking when the PHN so should visit a postpartum after birth, and this is okay, this is happening at home. Remember this one class, ha, hindi si pasyente class yung magfa-follow up to the hospital. Iba yon, it's in the obstetric, okay, concept. It's in maternal and child nursing. But in the context of this question, it is being asked in a community health nursing concept. Of course, the answer should be within, isulat ninyo class, within 72 hours. Within 72 hours. Or for these options class, remember, it should be after 3 days. Okay? You got it right class? It should be after 3 days. Tandaan mo yan class, ha? Okay? Again, after 3 days. Okay. Now, let's continue to your number 18. A nurse must know that vitamin A supplementation for mothers in postpartum should be, i-highlight ko lang yung vitamin A na word class because sometimes ang ating board of nursing, mahilig sila sa renaming since this is otherwise known as your retinol. Okay, now, when a nurse daw must know that vitamin A or retinol supplementation for mothers in postpartum should be, okay, sabi sa letter A, 200,000 IU for one dose only. Sabi sa letter B, 200,000 IU for two doses. Sabi sa letter C, 10,000 IU, okay, for two doses. And then letter D, 10,000 IU or international unit class, ha, international unit yan, for one dose only. So, class, remember that vitamin A supplementation is also needed for the mother, okay, and also for the baby, both for postpartum. Okay, it should be given in the postpartum period, at actually nagbibigay rin tayo, okay class, prenatal, in the prenatal period. Okay, habang nagpapa-check up si mother sa kanyang prenatal class, nagbibigay rin tayo. Ngayon, ang tanong, ilan ang binibigay natin or gaano kalaki yung amount na binibigay natin during the postpartum? Postpartum yung tinatanong dito. And the answer class dito class, okay, we are giving, okay, 200,000 for one dose only. Okay? Again, 200,000 IU for one dose only. So, wrong ito class si letter B because two doses. Of course, wrong si letter C, wrong si letter D because both gives 10,000 IU. So, the correct answer for this one is of course letter A. 200,000 international units for one dose only. But I have to highlight this one class, that this 10,000 IU for two doses only, this is given class during the, okay, during the prenatal visits, okay, again, during prenatal visits. But I have to highlight also class that we give vitamin A, isulatin nyo, we give vitamin A after 4 months. Okay, why class? Or we start at 4 months or after the first trimester. Bakit class? This is class a potent teratogenic agent. Okay, it has a potent teratogenic effect. Okay, teratogenic effect. You need to remember that. Kapag sinabi natin teratogenic effect, those are the substances or medications class that can harm our developing baby. Okay, so the correct answer for this question is of course letter A. Okay, number 19. The reproductive age. Okay, ano daw ang reproductive age ng tao dito sa Pilipinas class? Letter A, 15 to 49 years old. Letter B, 15 to 59 years old. Letter C, 15 to 30 years old. Letter D, none of the above. Remember, we are asking for the reproductive age. Okay, reproductive age. Kapag sinabi natin reproductive age in the Philippines, the correct answer for this one class is letter A. Wala nang iba. Okay? Wala nang iba. Letter A is the correct answer. Okay? That's right. Now, letter B is wrong. Why? Because this is the productive age. Sulat ninyo. This is the productive age in the Philippines. Okay? This is the productive age but not the reproductive age. Letter C is also wrong class because, of course, letter C is wrong class because this is the youth age in the Philippines. Okay? This is the youth age in PH. This is according to RA 8044. Okay? Ito class, none of the above, of course, this also is wrong. Okay? Now, number 20. In mainstreaming the family planning program in the country, the religious partner of Department of Health is letter A, the Catholic Bishops Conference of the Philippines. Letter B, Baptist Conference of the Philippines. Letter C, Brotherhood of Christians, a Christian businessmen and professionals. Letter D, Couples for Christ. Ito, medyo mahirap tong tanungan. Ito talaga yung mga tanungan na pang-board. Okay, board top-notchers. Okay, now, pero madali lang to. Honestly, if you know really the concept, if you were able to read the concept class, you know what? The partner of the government, of the DOH and mainstreaming the family planning program in the country is not the Catholic Bishops Conference of the Philippines, because predominantly the CBCP has actually been opposing, no, the passing of the reproductive health law in the country. Not, it's not also the Baptist Conference of the Philippines, okay? And it's not, of course, also the BCBP. But the correct answer for this one, okay, this is a top-notchers question. This is the Couples for Christ. So letter D is the correct answer. Tandaan niyo yan. Okay? Now, number 21. Which of the following is not a pillar of family planning program in the country? Alin daw sa mga sumusunod ang hindi pillar? Okay, isa-isahin natin. Birth spacing is a pillar. Okay, ang hinahanap natin is not. So, letter B, informed choices. Informed choices is also a pillar of the family planning program. Responsible parenthood is also a pillar. At dagdagan ko lang class, okay, And then number four, we also have number four class, respect for life. Okay? Respect for life. Respect for life. Sulatin nyo, respect for life. So the wrong answer or the correct answer kasi not yung hinahanap natin dito is letter D. Okay? Not included ang use of artificial family planning only. You need to remember the word only. That's a very dangerous term. Okay? That's why the correct answer for this one is letter D. Is the correct answer. Okay? Now, number 22. What is the role of the public health nurse in family planning? Ano daw ang role class dito? Sabi sa letter A, facilitator. Letter B, decision maker. Letter C, regulator. Letter D, none of the above. Okay, class, tandaan ninyo that the role of, a nurse class has a very vital role in family planning program. And ang pinaka-role talaga ni nurse class is he is the facilitator. Tandaan nyo yan class ha. He or she is the facilitator. It is the role of the RN, of the nurse. So A is the correct answer. Okay, letter B is wrong because decision maker class, it is the role of the family. Okay, the family is the decision maker. Letter C, regulator, this is class the role of the Department of Health. Okay, therefore letter D is also wrong. Okay, letter A is the best answer. Okay, number 23. What is the role of family in family planning? Okay, sinabi na natin kanina, what is the role of the family in family planning class? Of course, alam na natin to, that the role of the family is, of course, they are the decision maker. Okay? Alam na natin yan. Okay, now, number 24. Alam nyo, kapag ganito yung mga tanungan na sunod-sunod, and then you know the concept, it's a really a bonus part, okay, in the PNLE. What is the role naman of Department of Health in Family Planning? Okay, we now know that they are the regulator. Okay, ang role po ng Department of Health is they are the regulator class. Okay, C is the best answer. What is the normal volume of sperm cell per ejaculation? Ito, this is both a maternal question and it can also be asked in your CHN because of the Family Planning Program of the Philippines, which is a community concept, no? Okay, so sabi sa letter A, 2.5 to 5 ml. Letter B, 5 to 10 ml. Letter C, 10 to 15 ml. Letter D, 15 to 20 ml. Now, just imagine class, okay? Gaano daw kadami or gaano kadami nga yung volume ng sperm cell per ejaculation. Okay, the best answer for this one class is 2.5 to 5 ml. Just imagine class, yung isang syringe class, okay? Yung isang syringe na yung 5 ml, okay? Halimbawa, okay? This is 5 ml na syringe ha. Okay, 5 ml. Okay? Now, sabi ng konsepto class, per ejaculation, 2.5 daw, almost half class, okay, half ng syringe na to hanggang mapuno, yun yung amount ng sperm cell na lumalabas per ejaculation. So, ito masyadong mataas yung 5 to 10, 10 to 15, of course, yung 15 to 20. So, the correct answer for this one class is letter A, okay? Okay, number 26, what is the normal sperm count per ejaculation? And you need to remember, class, that ang pag-measure po nito is for per ml, okay? Now, sabi sa letter A, 50 to 150 million per ml. Letter B, 10 to 20 million per ml. Letter C, 150 to 500 million per ml. Letter D, 1 to 2 billion per ml. So, the correct answer class dito is letter, okay? The correct answer for this one, okay, you need to remember class that yung minsan class, kapag ranges yung ibinibigay sa atin, The bigger the range class, the better. Okay? So now, 10 to 20 million per ml class is a wrong answer. Okay? Actually, kapag below 20 class, that is already classified as infertility. Okay? Infertility. So 1 to 2 billion also is wrong. Masyadong mataas yan. So the question is 50 to 150 or 150 to 500. Of course, the correct answer for this one class is letter A. Okay? Remember that the normal sperm count is 50 to 150 million. So letter A is the best answer. Okay? Number 27. The ideal birth spacing should be, okay, this is in the Philippines, ha? Okay, according to the law, it's 3 years. Tandaan ninyo, tatlong taon po. Halimbawa, class, kung nakapanganak ka ngayon ng una mong anak, According to the law, the proper or the ideal birth spacing should be manganganak ka ulit or magkakaroon ka ng anak after 3 years. Okay? So, letter C is the correct answer. Number 28. It is the law that orders giving of hepatitis B vaccine at birth. Okay. Now, ano daw yung batas class na nagsasaad na dapat no magbigay ng hepatitis B vaccine during birth or at birth. Okay? Now the answer to this one class is of course letter A. Tandaan niyo, it's letter A. Okay? Letter B class RA9709 is the Newborn Hearing Screening Act. Okay, of the country. Ito naman class, this is the DRRM. Okay, law. Okay, and then class D letter D class, this is your UHC law in the country. Okay, tandaan ninyo. Okay, so letter A is the best answer. Number 29, ito kasasabi lang natin. RA9709 is otherwise known as the Newborn Hearing Screening Act of 2009. Okay, letter A is the best answer. Okay, number 30. A public health nurse must know that the earliest possible detection of congenital metabolic defect would be. Okay, sagot, letter A, 72 hours after birth. Letter B, 1 week after birth. Letter C, 72 hours after birth. Letter D, 1 month after birth. Simple lang ang tinatanong dito, class. When do we conduct daw, or I mean, when is the earliest possible na pwedeng mag-conduct tayo ng newborn screening, ha? Not the newborn hearing screening. Okay, ito po class yung gumagamit tayo ng Hill prick method sa paa ni baby class, na kung saan class, okay, pinapa-bleed natin class, okay, yung paa, and then ilalagay natin class yung blood class sa apat na, okay, sa paper, okay, and then this will be submitted later on. Okay, to the newborn screening center. It could be either in Manila or kapag Visayas nasa Iloilo, and then in Mindanao nasa Davao. Okay, and of course you will be having the result within 3 months. Okay, for you to know if meron bang metabolic congenital anomaly si baby. Okay, so now according to the book class, the earliest possible class na pwede is, of course, it's 24 hours, okay, of life. But you need to remember that this is the earliest possible, earliest. Pero hindi dyan kinakandak because this is very, very prone to have a false result. So the correct answer, class, dapat kapag tinatanong kayo kung when is newborn screening conducted, class, it should be 72 hours. But in so far as this question is concerned, because ang tinatanong class is the earliest possible, okay, the answer is letter C. Okay? 24 hours after birth. Number 31. The method used in newborn screening is A, intravascular prick method. Letter B, intraosseous prick method. Letter C, Hill prick method. Letter D, vastus lateralis prick method. Of course, alam natin to, letter C, Hill prick method. Okay? And you need to remember that you need, before class, pricking class, you need to facilitate the vasodilation. Okay? Vasodilation. So, how do we do that? Dapat warm ang kamay ni nurse. Okay? So, dapat warm rin class ang skin. And you need to remember class that in keeping the heel class warm, we don't have to use class, okay, yung hot water talaga, because there were some cases class, or there was once a case of negligence wherein yung ginamit talagang water is not just warm but it was a hot water, so nagkaroon ng first degree burn yung baby. So we need to be very careful with that. So heel prick method po ang ginagamit natin dyan. Number 32, who may conduct newborn screening? A, doctor. Letter B, nurse. Letter C, medical technologist. Letter D, all of the above. You know what? As long as they are trained class, pwede po silang lahat. Okay? The correct answer is letter D, all of the above. Okay, number 33. Which of the following congenital defect cannot be detected through newborn screening? Letter A, congenital hypothyroidism. Letter B, G6PD. Letter C, tetralogy alpha low. Letter D, maple syrup urine disease or MSUD. So the correct answer for this one class is letter C. Okay? You know what? This cannot be detected through newborn screening. Okay? Tetralogy of Fallot. That's very, very impossible. Okay? So letter A, this can be detected. Letter B, G6PD, and also your MSUD or your maple syrup urine disease. Okay? Now, number 34. The following may be seen in a child with galactosemia, except alin daw ang hindi makikita. Okay? Sabi sa letter A. Okay? Sabi sa letter A, cataract. Sabi sa letter B, jaundice. Letter C, liver damage. Letter D, absence of kidney. Okay, isa-isahin natin. Cataract may be found, okay, can be found class in a patient with galactosemia. Jaundice can also be found. Liver damage can also be found. At idagdag po natin class, yung tinatawag natin kernicterus. Okay, kernicterus. Sulat ninyo. Kernicterus, okay? Kernicterus, which is, ito naman po is yung yellowish discoloration of the eyes. And also, idagdag po natin yung tinatawag nating damage or kidney damage. Letter E and then letter F, okay? I mean, letter D and letter E, okay? Kidney damage. However, hindi po pwede class na humantong na talagang totally walang kidney. So, kasi except yung hinahanap natin, absence of kidney is the best answer for this one. Hindi po yan kasama. You know what? This condition is what we call as your kidney agenesis. Okay? It's a neural tube defect class. It's a certain type of neural tube defect na kung saan the baby failed to develop kidney. Okay? And eventually, the patient will also die. Okay? At birth. So, ang tawag po natin dyan is absence of kidney, it's kidney agenesis. Okay? So, letter D is the best answer. Next, number 35. It is a congenital defect associated with hemolytic anemia and increased bilirubin, thereby causing massive jaundice leading to mental retardation. Letter A, G6PD. Letter B, phenylketonuria. Letter C, hypothyroidism. Letter D, MSUD. So, the best answer for this one class, kapag sinabi natin bilirubin and also massive jaundice class, okay, leading to your mental retardation or MR class, ang answer natin dito class is your G6PD. Okay? G6PD. And remember class, talking about your G6PD, this is the highest most, okay, the highest most class na nadidetect class, okay, na metabolic congenital anomaly. Okay? So, the correct answer class is letter A. It is a defect caused by inability to break down amino acid. Letter A, phenylketonuria. Letter B, MSUD. Letter C, G6PD. Letter D, galactosemia. Okay. Now class, ang congenital anomaly po class na kung saan the baby class, the body of the baby failed to break down amino acid class. Ang tawag po natin dito class is your phenylketonuria. Okay? A is the best answer. Underline ko lang po yung amino acid is the phenylketonuria. Okay? So, letter A is the best answer. Number 37. How many disorders can be detected through newborn screening class? Okay. In our previous newborn screening class, okay, we have only 6 diseases class that can be detected. However, class, in the expanded newborn screening, we now have 28 diseases that can be detected. So, letter C is the correct answer. Okay, that's why class, kailangan po talaga natin i-update class ang ating mga knowledge, ha. Letter A is wrong. Letter B is wrong. Letter D is wrong. We need to be very careful class with the available resources class online because some of these concepts may have been obsolete na, okay, may bago na pong konsepto, and some of this contents class has been there actually even when I was still a student. So I started becoming a student in the year 2011, so it's very, very dangerous to just rely on those concepts available freely available, no, in the internet, because some of them again are maybe obsolete already. Okay, so letter C is the best answer. Number 38, if BCG vaccine was given and no scarring happened on the vaccination site, the best thing to do by the public health nurse is to what? Okay, we are now entering the expanded program of immunization program. Okay, now letter A, do nothing. Letter B, repeat the vaccination. Letter C, report to the Department of Health. Letter D, none of the above. You know what? If you are just following class, the expanded program immunization guidelines class, kapag hindi class nagkaroon ng scarring sa pagbibigay class ng inyong BCG, you need to have it class repeated. Letter B class is the correct answer. Okay? Letter B, repeat the vaccination. Okay? Of course. Letter A, do nothing class. Ito yung ginagawa ng tamad nating nurses. Okay, letter C, report to the Department of Health. Okay? And also, letter D, also wrong. Yung letter C class, advance mag-isip. Okay? Letter B, repeat the vaccination. Of course, you also need to note, no, that you have repeated, no, as part of your documentation. So, letter B is the correct answer. Number 39, which of the following vaccines is associated with convulsions? Okay, letter A, BCG. Letter B, hepatitis B. Letter C, DPT. Letter D, OPV. Okay? Alam nyo, class, this is a very, very tricky question, and this is also an easy question if you already know the concept. However, maraming estudyante po ang nagkakamali dito sa question na to. So, the correct answer for this one class is your not OPV, it's not BCG, neither your hepatitis B. The correct answer for this one is your DPT or your diphtheria pertussis tetanus vaccine. Okay? Remember, class, that it can cause the convulsion. Okay, however, class, ganito, meron po tayong marker dyan, your 3 days period. Parang 3 months rule, no? Pero dito, it's the 3 days rule. Sabi dito, sabi sa libro, class, kapag daw any convulsion, class, happen within 3 days after the vaccination, it has something to do with DPT. Okay? But if it occurs 3 days after the vaccination, it has nothing to do with your DPT. Okay? Tandaan ninyo. Okay? Sabi sa number 40, an infant's mother told the PHN that her child had a seizure a day after the last time it had a vaccination with DPT. The best thing to do by the nurse is to letter A, hold the next dose of DPT. Letter B, continue giving DPT. Letter C, explain that the convulsion has nothing to do with the vaccines. Letter D, ignore the mother. Her concern is opinionated. Okay? Alam nyo, obviously, maling-mali si letter D. Okay? We do not ignore our clients in the community class. Okay? Letter C, explain that the convulsion. Remember our marker, 3 days. Remember the 3 days rule, class, in your DPT class. Kapag sinabi natin, class, na DPT, remember the 3 days rule. Kapag nag-convulsion within 3 days, class, it has something to do with DPT. Kapag after 3 days, class, naman, it has nothing to do with it. Okay? Now, letter B is wrong. Do not give, class. Okay? Kasi nga, a day after, okay, ang marker natin. Also, do not explain that the convulsion has nothing to do with the vaccines kasi nga, nangyari siya within 3 days rule. Okay? So, the correct answer for this one is letter A. Hold muna yung next dose ng DPT and then you report, okay, the case to the health officer. Letter A is the correct answer. Number 41. Which of the following vaccines is least sensitive to heat? Letter A, DPT. Letter B, OPV. Letter C, BCG. Letter D, hepatitis B. Okay, again, tinatanong natin, what is the least sensitive na vaccine, class? The correct answer for this one, okay, for this enumeration, ha, letter A, DPT, letter B, OPV, letter C, BCG, letter D, hepatitis B. The correct answer for this one, class, okay? The correct answer, the least sensitive to heat. Meron tayo dito, class, tinatawag nating, para mas madali nating maalala, kung least talaga yung tinatanong, class, the most least talaga is your TT, That's why it's least TT, okay? Pero in the case dito class, since wala po dito class yung ating TT in the options class, you do not answer OPB because you do not answer OPB, wrong po ang letter B, because it's the most. It's actually the most. That's why kapag sinabing most, you answer OPV. Okay, the most sensitive is the OPV. Okay, letter A, DPT, letter C, BCG, letter D, hepatitis B, but the most sensitive dito class among the options class is actually your BCG. So the correct answer for this one is your letter C. BCG is the correct answer. Okay? Number 42. Okay, which of the following is most sensitive to heat? Alam na natin yan class, sinabi na natin kanina. That's why the correct answer for this one is letter B. OPV is the correct answer. Most, okay, sensitive to heat. Number 43. A public health nurse should stop giving vaccinations to the following except, okay, letter A, convulsion within 3 days post-vaccination. Okay, letter B, evolving neurologic disease. Letter C, uncontrolled epilepsy. Letter D, common colds. Sagot, the correct answer for this one class is of course, kapag may common colds lang class, that's why it's just common because it's a type of common colds lang naman. Okay, you may still give no vaccination kasi yung hinahanap po natin is exempt. Okay, so the best answer for this one is letter D, common colds. Okay, number 44. Which of the following vaccines contain a live attenuated virus? Okay, yung tinatanong class ha, is a live attenuated virus. Okay, A, OPV, letter B, BCG, letter C, rotavirus, letter D, DPT. Okay? The correct answer for this one class is letter, okay, it's letter, actually, we have two correct answers for this one, okay? It can be letter A, it can also be letter C, okay? Your BCG class, this is your live attenuated bacteria and that virus, okay? Live attenuated bacteria and that virus. And in letter D, DPT class, this is a weakened toxin, okay? This is a weakened toxin, okay? So the correct answer can be your letter A or letter C, okay? Number 45. Which of the following daw vaccines contain a live weakened toxin? So alam na natin to, sinabi na natin, the correct answer class is your DPT, live weakened toxin. Number 46. Ano naman daw na vaccine ang live attenuated bacteria? Okay, kasasabi lang natin class, the correct answer for this one is your BCG. Okay, BCG is the correct answer. Number 47. In what year was the Philippines considered a polio-free country? Okay, anong taon daw diniklaran ang Pilipinas class is a polio-free country? Letter A, 2005. Letter B, 2000. Letter C, 1995. Letter D, 2020. The correct answer class, we were declared polio-free country in the year 2000 class. Nang anong bansa class? We were declared class a polio-free country by the country of Japan. Tandaan po natin class, ang Japan po ang nagsabi sa atin that we are a polio-free country. Okay, it was Japan, okay, who told us, no, na polio-free country tayo. So, best answer for this one is 2000. Eto, what country declared the Philippines? Alam mo na, isagot mo na class. Okay, the best answer for this one is of course letter D, Japan. Okay? Number 49. It is a government campaign to promote positive childcare behavior. Sabi sa letter A, Sentrong Sigla Movement. Letter B, 10 Commandments. Letter C, First 1,000 Days. Letter D, Garantisadong Pambata. Alam nyo, minsan, in the boards, we don't really need to think outside the box because the answer can actually just be found within the bounds of the question class. Okay? So, remember, child care. Okay? So, the best answer dito is garantisadong pambata. Okay? No-brainer. Letter D is the correct answer. Okay? Now, number 50. Garantisadong pambata program is for what age group? Sabi sa letter A, 10 years old and above. Okay, letter B, below 5 years old. Letter C, below 1 year old. Letter D, 15 to 30 years old. Immediately, class, you scrape out, class, your letter D because this is the youth age again. Okay? It covers adolescent and then the young adults class and even the adulthood class na ages, no? Now, 1 year old class, you also eliminate this one because this is for infants. Okay? Kasama sila sa class sa program na tinatawag natin F1KD or the first 1,000 days. Okay? Letter B, below 5 years old. Letter A, 10 years old and above. So, the correct answer for this one is not 10 years old and above, but if, of course, you're below 5 years old. This is otherwise known as the program na under 5 program. Okay? Under 5 po ang term nito sa ating mga nurses sa communities. Okay? Garantisadong pambata program or under 5 program. Okay? Number 51. In infant and young child feeding, the earliest possible time for breastfeeding is letter A, at 6 months. Letter B, 6 months to 2 years. Letter C, 2 years and beyond. Letter D, at birth. Nakakalimutan natin, alam nyo, nung tinanong ko to sa mga students ko. They always forget, class, that the unang yaka protocol class is actually suggesting us, class, to, of course, already give, class, your breastfeeding at birth. Okay? The reason, class, why nagbibigay na tayo ng breastfeeding, class, at birth, that is also, class, to avoid, isulatin nyo, to avoid hypoglycemia, okay, of the baby. Okay? To avoid hypoglycemia. So, the correct answer for this one is letter D. Okay? Number 52. Exclusive breastfeeding means letter A, breast milk alone. Letter B, breast milk with water. Letter C, breast milk with vitamins. Letter D, all of the above. Alam nyo, kapag tinatanong kayo, that's why it's exclusive, class. Ang reason, class, bakit exclusive siya? Because it's breast milk alone. Okay? Letter A is the best answer. Wala nang iba. It's not, class, breast milk with water. Okay? It's not breast milk class with vitamins, okay? But it's, okay, breast milk alone. So, exclusive breastfeeding means breast milk alone, okay? Number 53, complementary breastfeeding is also known as, sabi sa letter A, early breastfeeding. Letter B, exclusive breastfeeding. Letter C, mixed bottle feeding. Letter D, extended breastfeeding. So, the correct answer for this one, class, minsan tinatawag kasi siyang extended breastfeeding, class. Okay? Of course, maling-mali na yung exclusive because it's actually the pure breast milk only. It's not early breastfeeding. Okay? It's not also mixed, lalong-lalo na ito, bottle feeding. Maling-mali na yan. Okay? The correct answer for this one, class, is letter D, extended breastfeeding. Okay? Number 52. According to the Philippine Integrated Management on Acute Malnutrition or PMAM, no, it's a program na napakaganda, no. Brain damage in children below 2 years old is letter A, irreversible. Letter B, reversible. Letter C, it can be reversible daw, pwede ring reversible. Okay? Letter D, none of the above. Alam nyo, ang tamang sagot dito, isa lang ang sagot dito, class, it's irreversible. That's why the F1KD program or the first 1,000 days, okay? The first 1,000, it's 1K because the first 1,000 days program or ang tawag nito dati sa Pilipinas, unang isang libong araw ni baby. First 1,000 days ni baby, alaga ni mommy. Okay, ito yung programa na kasama po natin ang World Health Organization at saka ang UNICEF. Okay? So, remember that kailangan ang first 1,000 days alagaan natin, class, because brain damage, class, is irreversible. Okay? Letter A is the correct answer. Number 55. Which of the following is not an element of EPI or the Expanded Program on Immunization Program? A, target setting. Letter B, information dissemination. Letter C, cold chain logistics. Or letter D, none of the above. Okay. Alam nyo, kapag EPA yung pinag-usapan natin, class, simple lang ang isasagot ninyo, class. Ang hindi kasama dyan, kasama po dyan ang target setting, of course, alam natin yan. Information dissemination, cold chain logistics, kasama po lahat yan. Of course, wala po dyan hindi kasama. Okay? The correct answer class is letter D, none of the above. Okay? So now, let's continue to your number 56. Which of the following is not a child-specific survival intervention in the Philippines? Okay. Sabi sa letter A, essential intrapartum and newborn care. This is the unang yakap protocol. Okay? Unang yakap. Okay? Letter B, expanded program on immunization. This is EPI. Okay? Integrated management of childhood illnesses. This is your IMCI. At lahat po ito, letter A, letter B, letter C, sila po ay child-specific survival intervention in the Philippines. Ang hindi po kasama dyan is letter D, National Tuberculosis Program. This is the program class na ibinababa ng gobyerno, but specific for TB, but the strategy po natin na ginagamit is your TB dots. Okay, may TB dots pa rin po tayo sa Pilipinas class. Okay, the correct answer for this one is letter D. It's not a child-specific program. Ang child-specific ko dito is your letter A, B, and letter C. So, D is the correct answer. Number 57, National Immunization Day. Anong araw daw class ang ating National Immunization Day? Sagot class, it's Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday. It's actually, sagot class, it's actually Wednesday. Okay? Wednesday po ang ating National Immunization Day. Sagot, it's letter C. Okay. Number 58. Which of the following vitamins and minerals is not under the food fortification law? Okay. Anong daw sa mga sumusunod na vitamins and minerals class? Ang hindi kasama sa food fortification law. Sabi dito, this is now the nutrition programs po, no, ng gobyerno. Letter A, iron. Letter B, vitamin A. Letter C, iodine. Letter D, zinc. Sagot, alam nyo po, class, ang ating pong kasama dyan. Remember, just remember the 45. Kapag sinabi natin 45, this is your iron, your vitamin A, and then your, okay, iodine. Sagot, five. Okay? Letter A is part of the food fortification law. Vitamin A is also one. Iodine is also one, but not zinc. So, zinc is the correct answer. Okay? Kasi yung hinahanap natin, it's not under the food fortification law. Okay? Sagot, it's letter D, zinc. Okay? Number 59. Ito. This is a very, very good question, class. What is the richest or the major source of protein in the Filipino diet? Eto, maraming nagkakamali din dito eh. No, munggo, letter A, munggo, letter B, fish, letter C, rice, letter D, egg. Alam nyo, kapag tinatanong po natin to sa ating review centers, most of the students would answer fish, mostly would answer egg, mostly would answer munggo. May some rin naman na sumasagot ng rice. But the correct answer for this one class is your rice. Remember class, ang mental model kasi natin kapag sinabing rice class, immediately pumapasok sa ating isipan is just, it only contains, no, carbohydrates. Kasi nga, lumaki tayo, the go growth, glow foods. So, yung rice immediately nasa go, no? And then alam natin na, hindi yan, it's more of the carbs, but it's not more of protein. But it has actually protein content. At tanong, ang remember na ang tanong class, in the Filipino diet. So, you are about to answer. That's why sinasabi ko, tinuulit-ulit ko sa mga estudyante ko class, na kapag you are answering or you are about to take the Philippine Nurse Licensure Examination, yung basahin mo ay yung mga librong pang Philippine setting. Okay? Yung may nakasulat na libro, not for sale outside the Philippines, because all of these concepts class ay pinag-usapan in the Filipino setting. Okay, and that's the danger class kung purong-purong NCLEX books po ang ating binabasa. Okay, now, ang konsepto po dito, because alam natin that in the Filipino setting, the Filipino diet class, lahat tayo, ang common na meron tayong palagi sa pagkainan, okay, is rice, ang kanin, no? Kahit nga asin, pwede nating ulamin eh, no? Kahit crackers, minsan inuulam natin. Pero ang hindi nawawala talaga, it's the rice. Okay, pwedeng wala tayong fish everyday, pwedeng wala tayong munggo everyday, pwedeng wala tayong egg everyday, but the concept dito is malagi tayong merong rice, okay? So, the correct answer dito class is letter C. Rice is the best answer. Number 60, how will you determine products that underwent food fortification law? Paano mo daw malalaman, class, na ang isang produkto ay meron, no, or dumaan sa food fortification? Letter A, nutritional facts. Letter B, isang cup Pinoy seal. Letter C, ISO certified seal. Letter D, expiration date. Alam niyo yung maling-mali class ng letter D, ha? Okay. A, B, or C, the correct answer, class, dito is your sangkap Pinoy seal. Yan. Ito, class, yung may araw. Di ba yung parang nasa pakete? Tapos yung may araw na nakaganyan, tapos nakangiti siya. Okay? Araw ng sangkap Pinoy yan, eh. Ang tawag dyan, no? Nakaganyan, tapos nakaganyan. So, yan. Dumaan yan sa food fortification. Okay? The correct answer is letter B is the best answer. Okay? Araw ng sangkap Pinoy seal. Or the sangkap Pinoy seal. Number 61. Which of the following is the strategy used by the government in delivering the nutritional guidelines for Filipinos? Ito, remember, class, nutritional guidelines for Filipinos. Okay, very, very clear na to. It's not F1KD, class. Very, very English, oh, no? It's not garantisadong pambata, class. Okay? It's not garantisadong pambata. Okay? But if it's, of course, 10 commandments. Okay? Letter D is also wrong. Okay, the correct answer for this one, class, is your letter C. 10 commandments, di ba? Alam nyo, always to din, parang nasa ads to in the radio, eh. Ang 10 commandments, parang ganon, no? Okay, it is the strategy used by the government in delivering the nutritional guidelines for Filipinos. Okay, C is the best answer. Number 62. Which of the following is not included in the strategy used by the government in delivering the nutritional guidelines for Filipinos? Letter E, A, eat variety of foods. Letter B, consumption of imported products. Letter C, breastfeeding. Letter D, consume protein. Of course, it's very, very obvious that ito, letter B is the correct answer. Hindi siya kasama, not included. Imported products, oh, that's a very dangerous term. Okay? B is the correct answer. Eat variety of foods is correct. Breastfeeding is correct. Consumption of protein is also correct. Okay? So, the correct answer for this one is letter B is the correct answer. Number 63. Food assistance program in the Philippines targets the following population except ano daw ang hindi kasama, okay, sa food assistance program ng bansa, no? Letter A, stunted children. Letter B, wasted children. Letter C, pregnant women. Letter D, patient with HIV and AIDS. So the correct answer for this one, class, kasama si stunted, kasama si wasted, kasama si pregnant, and also isama niya rin na rin, class, letter D on the list, class, is your lactating women. Okay, lactating women. So the correct answer for this one, class, is letter D. Okay, patients with HIV and AIDS. Correct answer, class, is letter D. Okay, number 64. National Salt Iodization Program is mandated by, this is otherwise known, class, as the Fidel Law. Okay, isinabatas po ito sa panahon ni dating Pangulong Fidel Ramos, no? So, National Salt Iodization Program is mandated by what law daw? Sabi sa letter A, RA 11223. Letter B, RA 10121. Letter C, RA 9288. Letter D, RA 8172. Okay? Sagot, class, it's not, class, alam natin to, this is UHC law. Inulit natin to kanina. This is your DRRM law. This is also your newborn screening law. Okay, this is your newborn screening. This one, class, is your DRRM law. Okay, so the correct answer, class, is your letter D option. Okay, correct answer is, of course, letter D. Tandaan natin, isulat natin yan. National Salt Iodization Program is mandated under RA 8172. Okay, next, number 65. RA 8172 was enacted to eliminate letter A, iron deficiency, letter B, iodine deficiency, letter C, protein deficiency, letter D, carbohydrates deficiency, class. That's why it's salt iodization law, because it targets to eliminate, okay, iodine deficiency. Okay, letter B is the correct answer. Okay, iodine deficiency, the correct answer is letter B. Number 66. Which of the following is not a strategy, no, for food assistance program among population. Okay. Ano daw sa mga sumusunod ang hindi, no, strategy na ginagamit ng government for food assistance program among population? Sabi sa letter A, Zumba sessions. Letter B, rice distribution. Letter C, food discounts. Letter D, livelihood assistance. Okay. Sagot? Okay. Rice distribution class is one, food discounts class is one, livelihood assistance class is also another one, except class, okay, your Zumba sessions, okay? Zumba sessions class is not included, no, in food assistance program. Tandaan ninyo, food assistance o, pwedeng lifestyle assistance or whatsoever, but it's not included in the food assistance program. Correct answer class dyan is letter A, okay? Number 67. In improving oral health in the country, which strategy in oral health program was used by the government? A. Bridging leadership. Letter B. Social mobilization. Letter C. Servant leadership. Letter D. House-to-house campaign. You know what? Ang oral health program po natin, remember, the oral health month is always done every February. This has been asked once in the words. At ang ginagamit po dito ang strategy ng government is not your bridging leadership. It's not house-to-house campaign, and it's not also servant leadership, but it's what we call as your social mobilization. So, anong strategy po ito? Anong nasa loob ng strategy po na ito? Lahat ng mga ayan siya ng gobyerno, lahat ng mga sectors class ay pinag-isa-isa at nag-ambagan, no, para makabuo ng 1,000,000 sipilyo. Okay? Isang milyong sipilyo. Okay? Program. Okay? Para tulungan po yung ating mga kabataan, okay, to teach them how to do, no, the oral health, no, the proper way, no, of maintaining their oral health or oral hygiene. Okay? So, ang tawag po natin doon ay social mobilization. Okay? So, what is the most effective promotion activity for oral health? Letter A, instructing oral hygiene techniques. Letter B, teaching about proper brushing of teeth. Letter C, informing signs of tooth decay. Letter D, all of the above. Just remember, class, that the most effective class promotion activity is health, oral health teaching. Okay? Oral health teaching. Ganun lang yan ka-simple, class. Okay? At dito, all of these three class, instructing, teaching, informing, lahat sila ay health teaching. So, the correct answer, class, is all of the above. Okay? 68, letter D is the correct answer. Okay? Number 69. In the social mobilization strategy of the government, which of the following program was used? Ano daw, no, na strategy, no? Or anong program yung ginamit? A. Lollapalooza. Letter B. 1,000,000 ngiti. Letter C. 1,000,000 sipilyo. Letter D. Oh, why don't you smile, my only star? This is parang kanta to, no? Yung letter D. Oh, why don't you smile, my only star? Di ba? Ganon. Okay. Wrong po yung letter D. Okay. Of course, wrong din po yung letter A. So, the correct answer for this one, class, is letter C. Sinabi na natin kanina to, class, 1,000,000 sipilyo. Okay? Ito po yung program na ginamit natin on our strategy of social mobilization. Letter C is the correct answer. Number 70. The legal mandate for care of older people is enshrined under what? Law. Okay, anong batas daw, class, ang nagsasaad, no, ng care for our older people? Okay? So, letter A, 10121. Okay? Is not an answer. Inulit to, DRRM yan. Ito naman, again, this is UHC law. Ito naman, class, ito naman, hindi rin yan yung tamang sagot, class, because it's your newborn hearing screening. Okay? Newborn hearing screening. Okay? So, the correct answer for this one, class, the legal mandate, class, for the care of our healthy, no, older Filipinos, class, or the aging Filipinos, is your RA 9257. So, tandaan po natin na may vision po sila. Ang vision po nila is healthy, sulat ninyo, healthy aging, okay, healthy aging for all Filipinos, or all Filipinos. Okay, ito po yung mandato ng batas na to. Okay? At ito pa yung vision nila. A healthy aging for all Filipinos. So, letter D is the best answer. Number 71. Ito. Papasok na tayo. You know what? COPAR, isa ito sa pinakamatagal ng konsepto class. However, tinatanong pa rin siya sa boards. Okay? This is a very, very landmark question. I mean, landmark topic in the year 2014. Okay? Yung tanong, which of the following discusses the importance of COPAR? Letter A, it is a tool for community development and people empowerment. Letter B, it prepares people for the management of a development programs in the future. Letter C, maximize community participation and involvement. And community resources are mobilized for community services. So the correct answer for this one class, lahat po sila tama. This defines COPAR. So the best answer for this one is all of the above. Okay? Sagot is all of the above. Number 72. COPAR stands for A, Center for Organizational and People-Acted Research. Letter B, Community Organization Towards Participatory and Active Philippines. Letter C, Community Organizing Participatory Action for Resolution. Letter D, none of the above. Alam nyo, COPAR stands for, tama na sana si letter C, Community Organizing Participatory Action, pero dapat it should be research. Action, research. Yung R sana dyan is should be research. So, mali si letter A, class. Mali rin si letter B. Mali si letter C. The correct answer for this one, class, is none of the above. Okay? None of the above. So, the D is the best answer. Number 73. Which of the following defines community organizing? Letter A, a process by which a community identifies its needs, an objective, develops confidence to take action, and develops cooperative and collaborative attitudes and practices in the community. Letter B, a process consists of steps or activities that instill and reinforce the people's self-confidence on their own collective strengths and capabilities. Letter C, a process whereby the community members develop the capability to assess their health needs and problems, plan and implement actions to solve these problems, put up and sustain organizational structures which will support and monitor implementation of health initiatives by the people. You know what? Community organizing is defined as everything po. Okay, all of the above is the best answer. Okay? Sulat nyo na yan. Okay, number 74. What is the goal of action research in COPAR? Letter A, profit-based inquiry. Letter B, promote change among participants. Letter C, to include all people in the community in decision-making. Letter D, to identify best solutions by the community alone. Okay? Sagot, plus it's not the action research class, the goal of this one is not for profit inquiry. Okay, that's why letter A class is wrong. To promote change among participants, pwede. To include all people in the community in decision making, pwede. So the best answer for this one class, it's not to identify best solution by the community alone, because you are their class. Because you are there to facilitate, no? Okay? So, the best answer for this one, class, is your letter. Okay? The best answer for this one is your letter C. Okay? Is the best answer. Number 75. In COPAR, it is necessary that the members of the core group must be those who are elected in public position. This statement is letter A, false. Letter B, true. Letter C, neither true or false. Letter D, none of the above. Alam nyo, hindi dapat class ha, maling-mali class na yung nasa position or elected lang dapat class in public position. No. Okay? Meron po tayong sinusunod dyan na guidelines in selecting. It could be that they are highly influential. Okay? Highly influential. Okay? They are influential class. Okay? They are respected or having this reputable man in the community, respected, high, widely influential, and is also a productive member of the society or of the community. So the correct answer for this one class is this is false. Okay, correct answer is false. Okay, letter B is wrong, letter C is also wrong, and letter D is of course also wrong. So the best answer is letter A. Number 76. Generally, COPAR has how many phases? Alam nyo, COPAR has actually 5 phases in general. Okay? Okay, letter C is the correct answer. So what are these phases? Number letter A is the pre-entry phase. Okay, pre-entry phase. Number one is the pre-entry. Number two is the entry phase. Okay, number three class is your working phase. Sometimes it is also known as your intervention phase or implementation phase. It could also be. And the number four class, ito na po yung ating tinatawag nating exit phase. Okay? And then number five is your sustenance phase. Pero, alam nyo class, that itong dalawang to, minsan they are used interchangeably because exit class can be done, no? After your sustenance. Kasi kailangan mo munang tulungan yung community to make the linkages. Your number 5 can also be your number 4 and then your number 4 can also be your number 5. So, the correct answer for this one is your letter C. 5 phases. Okay? Number 77. Which of the following is an activity during the pre-entry phase? Ano daw sa mga sumusunod na activity during the pre-entry phase of Copark? Letter A, community selection. Letter B, courtesy call to barangay chairman. Letter C, community consultations or dialogues. Or letter D, all of the above. Alam nyo, tama po si letter A, letter B, and letter C. The answer for this question is letter D. Ginagawa po natin ang community selection dito at may guidelines po rin po tayo dyan. And then courtesy call also is done to the barangay chairman. And then initial dialogues and consultations to the community is also done in this phase. So the correct answer for this one is letter D, all of the above. Okay? Number 78. In selecting a site for conduct of community organizing, all of the following must be taken into consideration except aling daw ang hindi dinagawa. Letter A, socio-economic status of the community. Letter B, whether or not health services are accessed by the community. Letter C, the peace and order situation of the community. Letter D, the total number of people exercising their rights to suffrage. Alam nyo, we will look at the social economic status of the community, yung health services, kung gaano pa kaganda, kasi yun yung target natin to make a change. The peace, kasi also for the security, no, ng mga tao na bababa for the community organizing. But except for the total number of people exercising their rights to suffrage or voting. Okay, it's not election po, okay? So the correct answer for this one is letter D is the best answer. Number 79. How many number of families a community must have for a public health nurse to start community organizing? Sabi sa letter A, 400 to 500 families. Letter B, 1,000 to 200 to 2,000 families. Letter C, 5 to 10 families. Letter D, 100 to 200 families. Alam nyo, ang tamang sagot dito, class, it should be 100 to 200 families, no? For you to start, okay, community organizing. Okay? Letter D is the best answer. No other answer. Number 80. The following are examples of demographic profile to be gathered in entry phase, no? Anong daw, no, ang mga kailangan natin? Select all that apply. Letter A, total population. Letter B, population density. Letter C, age and sex composition. Letter D, patterns of migration. Letter E, number of crimes. Letter F, population projection. Okay? Alam nyo, remember, kung anong demographic data or profile ang kukunin natin, it has something to do dapat with the population of the community. Okay? It has something to do with the population of the community. A is correct. Okay? A is correct. Population density is correct. Age and sex, it has something to do with your population. Patterns of migration, it has something to do with your population. Number of crimes is not included class. Okay? It has nothing to do. Police ka ba? Okay? Letter D, population letter F, population projections is also 1. Okay? So, A, B, the correct answer for this one is A, B, C, D, and F. Okay? So, that's the correct answer. Number 81. In COPAR, the most important tool that the PHN must use is letter A, attitude. Letter B, communication. Letter D, C, educational degree. Letter D, buy-in strategy. Alam nyo, it's a very simple tool and it's what we call as your communication. Okay? Communication po, yung means of channeling natin ng nais nating mangyari for the community. So, B is the best answer. Okay? Number 82. Data collected in entry phase include letter A, demographic data. Letter B, socioeconomic indices. Letter C, health indices. Letter D, all of the above. Alam nyo, it's all of the above. Tama po, lahat po ito class kailangan natin, no? Demographic data, socioeconomic indices, and health indices para po natin mabuo yung ating tinatawag na community organizer or community analysis, okay? Situational analysis of the community, okay? The all of the above is the best answer. Number 83. What method is not used in gathering data in community profiling? Letter A, interviews. Letter B, observations. Letter C, apprehension. Letter D, examination of secondary data. You know what? We conduct interviews para malaman natin yung mga problema in the community. We also do observations. We simply use our eyes, no? And examination also ang mga secondary data that exists in the community except for apprehension. Naka-apprehension po, not used kasi yung hinahanap natin. Ha. Yung apprehension, it's parang interrogative in nature. So we don't use that, no, in your community profiling. Sagot, letter C is the best answer. Number 84, Carla is a public health nurse planning to conduct interview for community profiling. In which setting can Carla best conduct an interview? A. During snack time. Letter B. During prayer meetings. Letter C. Schedule house-to-house calls. Letter D. On fiestas. You know what? It should not be during the snack time kasi nga it's snack time eh. It's the time allotted of the community to consume their snacks. Okay? And letter B. Of course, very religious session. Oh. And letter D. Also a religious session. You know what? The best time to conduct this one is your schedule. In the first place, schedule siya. So, nakapag-prepare po yung tao natin, no? House to house call. So, letter C is the best answer. Okay? C is the best answer. Number 85. In selecting community leaders, which of the following should not be included as a criterion by Nurse Carla? Letter A, Ronnie. 42 years old who belong to the poor and is actively participating in production. Alam na natin to, productive dapat, di ba? So, A, kasama yan. Kasi yung hinahanap natin class, not included. Okay. Mang Danny, 62 years old, who knows the myths and the old stories in the community. Mang Danny, 62 years old, alam niya yung mga haka-haka, yung mga myths, yung mga kwentong bayan, no? So, old stories in the community. So, perhaps meron siyang respect. A very reputable person na yan, si Mang Danny. Letter C, Albert, 30 years old, who wants to create an impact in the community. Eto, oh, willing, oh. And then, letter D, Dave, 45 years old, who owns a restaurant in the next city. So, the best answer for this one, class, pwede rin class, oh, willing to, wants to participate, class si Albert. So, the best answer, class, dito is letter D. Si Dave, porket mayaman kasi may restaurant, class. Okay? Should not be included in the criterion, class, for creating of your community leaders. Okay? D is the best answer. Number 86. Informing core group in the community, the most important training to be given is, wala nang iba class, ho? Okay? Alam nyo, kapag tinatanong kayo, the most important training for the core group na binubuo natin in the concept of COPAR class, it's always self-awareness. Okay? Self-awareness trainings. Okay? Self-awareness leadership trainings because they are about to become leaders. That's why it's leadership trainings. Okay? A is the best answer. Number 87. It is the process that entails formulation of steps, no, to be undertaken in the future in order to achieve a desired end. It takes place in order to efficiently allocate available resources. This is what we call as your, the best answer for this one class, it's what we call as your planning. Yan. Ginagawa po natin ang formulation of steps. Ayan, nagpaplano tayo, no, to be undertaken in the future in order to achieve a desired end. Planning po. Okay? And in COPAR, it's very, very important, no, na dapat gumagawa tayo ng very comprehensive planning na kasama always yung community. Okay? 87A is the best answer. Number 88. Nurse Carla should take note that all of the following are criteria for evaluation of COPAR except, okay, letter A, effectivity, letter B, efficiency, letter C, appropriateness, letter D, novelty. Alam nyo, effectivity is also a criteria, efficiency is a criteria, appropriateness, actually these are the most important criteria except for your novelty. Kasi hinahanap natin, okay, except, okay, novelty is not a criteria, okay? D is the best answer. Number 89. It is an important activity in sustenance phase of GOPAR, which also means networking. Okay, ano daw yung other term natin for networking and then collaboration? Letter A, padrino activity. Alam nyo, padrino activity, this is a very negative connotation. No? Padrino, ibig sabihin yan, this is the palakasan. And we don't want this one to happen in the community. So, A is the best. A is the best mistake. Okay, it's a wrong answer. Okay, letter B, courtesy calls. Letter C, linkaging. Letter D, solicitations. Okay, the best answer for this one is, of course, alam mo yan, it's linkaging. Kapag sinabi natin linkaging, this is same as your networking and then collaboration. Okay, letter C is the correct answer. Okay, next, number 90. To properly account all activities of the community organizing, one must be done by the public health nurse. Okay? Ano daw ang gagawin? A, provide daily diaries. Letter B, take pictures of activities with consent. Letter C, communicate all updates to the team. Letter D, all of the above. Alam natin to, these are very desirable class na activities, no, in community organizing. So the best answer for this one is all of the above. Okay? All of the above is the correct answer. Okay? Number 91. Eto, these are naman the commonly asked no questions from 91 until 100. Who is the chairman of the local health board? A, municipal health officer. Letter B, public health nurse. Letter C, provincial DOH officer. Letter D, local chief executive. Alam nyo, kasi yung hinahanap nyo palate, okay, it's the mayor, it's the governor, yan. Yan yung hinahanap natin, di ba? But your mayor, your governor, they are actually the local chief executive of a certain local government. Okay? That's why the best answer for this question is letter D, the local chief executive. Okay, sulat ninyo, the chairman of the local health board is the local chief executive and the vice chair is the health officer. Okay, it can be your PHO, your provincial health officer, or your municipal or city health officer. Okay, sagot, it's letter D dito, local chief executive. Ito, tinanong, who is the vice chairman of the local health board? It's not the mayor, kasi sinabi na natin the local chief executive, it's not the DOH officer, it's not the public health nurse, but of course, class, okay, it's the municipal health officer. Okay, the best answer, class, is your municipal health officer. Letter A is the best answer. Number 93, what is the universal precaution for avoidance of communicable diseases? Kapag tinanong ang universal precaution, class, kapag lumabas ito, class, i-highlight ko lang ha, kapag lumabas ang universal precaution, you immediately answer hand washing. Wala nang iba, class. It's the most important tool, it's the most important way to avoid communicable diseases. A, hand washing is the best answer. Okay? A is the best answer. Number 94. What is the end goal of community health programs? Letter A, to avoid diseases. Letter B, to maintain harmony. Letter C, to educate people. Letter D, to improve quality of life. Alam nyo, dito natin gagamitin yung tinatawag nating umbrella model. Okay, baka pag gumamit ka ng umbrella, class, okay? To avoid diseases is one. To maintain harmony is one. To educate people is one. To improve quality is above them all. So the correct answer for this question, class, is your letter D, to improve quality of life. Okay? B is the best answer. And that's the end goal of community health programs, to improve quality of life. Okay? D is the best answer. Number 95, what is the drug of choice for the treatment of malaria? Class, the drug of choice for the treatment of malaria, class, is letter A. It's your Artemether Lumefantrine. Tandaan nyo yan, class, ha? Okay, it's Artemether Lumefantrine. Your praziquantel is used for your cystosomiasis, or otherwise known as your bilharziosis. Your doxycycline, class, this can be used, class, as a how do you call this? As a prophylactic agent, class, for various infectious diseases. Now, your tetracycline is not correct answer, class. Okay? Okay, this is not wrong. This is not correct. Okay, the best answer for this one, class, is, of course, letter A, Artemether Lumefantrine. Okay. Eto, tinanong ulit. What is the drug of choice for treatment of cystosomiasis? Alam na natin yan. Isagot mo na. Isulat mo na. It's your praziquantel, class. It's your praziquantel. Okay? Praziquantel. Okay? Number 97. What is the causative agent for schistosomiasis? Class, letter A, S, japonicum. Letter B, S, aureus. Letter C, broglamalai. Letter D, wokicaria bancrofti or bancrofti. Alam nyo, this is schistosoma japonicum and this is staphylococcus aureus. Okay? Now, you could also have your schistosoma americanensis. Okay? Americanensis, which is common among American areas also, no? We also have the Schistosoma africanus, okay? So, those are common. And remember, class, ang common po dito na host or yung common class na pinaka-vector classes, we have your snail, okay? At ang family po ng snail na yan, class, is your Oncomelania. Isulat ninyo, Oncomelania quadrasi. Okay, Oncomelania quadrasi. So the best answer for this one is your Schistosoma japonicum. Okay? What is the causative agent for elephantiasis? Okay? Remember that your elephantiasis is otherwise known as your filariasis and the filariasis. Okay? And the common causative agent natin dyan, it's either your broglamalai, correct yan, which makes letter C correct, the broglamalai or your wokicaria bancrofti. Okay? Wokicaria bancrofti. So, the correct answer for this one, class, is letter C. Okay? What is the causative agent for Lyme disease? Ito, this is a very, very landmark question. No? Tinanong to one sa board. And the correct answer for this one is your Borrelia burgdorferi or your Borrelium groups. Okay? Okay? Borrelia. Borrelia or Borrelium family. Borrelia burgdorferi. So, D is the correct answer for this question. Okay? Number 100. Elephantiasis is otherwise known as letter A, bilharziasis. Filariasis. Letter C, ascaris. Letter D, schistosomiasis. Okay? Your bilharziasis, class, this is otherwise known as your schisto. Okay? So, ito po, other name niya ng schistosomiasis. So, the ascaris class is another infectious disease caused by your ascaris lumbricoides. Okay? Ascaris lumbricoides. Okay? Ascaris lumbricoides. So, the correct answer for this one, class, is your filariasis. Okay? Elephantiasis is otherwise known as your filariasis. So, that ends our 100 item rationalization in your community health nursing concept. I hope and I pray na may natutunan po kayo. Okay, subscribe to our channel and continue, no, na antabayan po ninyo ang mga next uploads po natin in your Junly Escala YouTube channel. Thank you and God bless.